In this illustration, we are going to evaluate the interaction energy of two dipoles. Here we can see a picture and the situation analyzes as the figure shows two dipoles P1 and P2 in a coordinate system. And we are required to find the interaction energy of the system of two dipoles. Now, we already studied in our conceptual videos that interaction energy of a dipole in an electric field is given as, this we can give as U is minus P dot E, where E is the electric field in which the dipole moment P is placed. Here there are two dipoles, that means we can say in the field of one dipole, another dipole is placed, so we can easily find out the interaction energy. And in this situation, first we can calculate the electric field at the location of P2 due to P1. Say in this situation due to P1, here if we analyze, this angle will be 45 degrees, which is taken from the axis of dipole. And with respect to this dipole, we can see the electric field 1 is in radial direction, which is ER, and as this negative charge is closer, ER will be directed towards P1. And the transverse electric field due to this dipole will be in this normal direction, which is E theta. So, due to these two electric fields, which exist at the location of P2, we can find out the interaction energy of P2 in these two dipoles, which are also at the angle 45 degrees with the dipole P2. Or, if we calculate the direction of ER E theta from P2, the direction between vectors will be 135 degrees. So in this situation, we can write due to P1 vector or the dipole moment 1, electric field components at location L,0R. Here we can write the radial electric field is given by, in magnitude it is 2kp cos theta by this distance cube, so I can write it 2kp1 cos 45 degree divided by root 2l whole cube, because the separation is this. Here I am taking 45 because I have already taken direction of ER over here. If I would not have taken the direction, I would have taken the angle 135 degree, so it won't make any difference. And here the value of transverse electric field will be KP1 sine 45 degree divided by root 12 whole cube. Now, in this situation, the values we are getting is, this is 2KP1 cos 45 is 1 by root 2, and this will be 2 root 2 L cube. So, this can be given as KP1 by 2 L cube. And this E theta will be given as KP1 by, this will be 4L cube. These are the values of electric field components due to dipole moment P1 vector at the location of P2. So now we can write down the interaction energy of P2 in the electric field of P1 vector is, this can be written as U is minus P2 dot E1. This is what we have studied earlier and we are applying it in this situation. So this can be written as minus of P2 vector, and we take its dot product with ER vector plus E theta vector. Now in this situation, if we take the dot product, this can be given as minus P2 dot ER will be P2 ER cos 135. So it will be P2 ER, we can substitute as KP1 by 2L cube, and cos 135 is minus 1 by root 2. Similarly, here we are having minus P2 dot E theta, that is KP1 by 4L cube multiplied by, again this cos 135 will take minus 1 by root 2. On simplifying, this will give us 2KP1 P2 by 2 root 2 L cube, and this will be added to this, so here it will become 2K, this KP1 P2 by 4 root 2 L cube. So it will be, here we can take he can cancel this negative sign here. And finally, we are getting 3 by 4 k p1 p2 by root 2 l cube. So that will be the answer to this problem.